This is the first video in a series introducing relational database design, SQL, and related concepts. This series is split up into 7 parts. This first part gives an introduction to databases and a motivation for using them. Subsequent parts will cover database design and SQL in detail, including how to create tables, manipulate data, and how to query data from tables using SQL. Subsequent videos will also provide extended demonstrations on how to use SQL and how to design a database from scratch. We'll start with a brief introduction to database concepts with some motivation on why we use databases. Consider the following table of data that models a course enrollment system. The data as presented is presented as a flat file, meaning that all data is stored in one table with columns and rows. Furthermore, there's no structure to this data, which can result in a lot of problems and data anomalies. First, there are formatting issues. Some of the student names are presented as first name, last name, while others are last name, comma, first name. Some names have initials instead of a full name. Some of the records store their names with an uppercase, lowercase variation, even though they belong to the same person. Another issue is that there's repeated data. Every record of a student enrolled in a particular course repeats the course name and number. Likewise, every student record repeats the name and the NUID. Such repetition is inefficient and unnecessary, but more importantly, it can lead to data anomalies and inconsistencies, as we previously noted. There's also incomplete data. The first and last record are missing data for their courses. These records exist to simply record different emails for the student. Moreover, the missing data is inconsistently represented. The first record uses empty strings, and the last uses the word none and null as flags to indicate missing data. All of these problems mean that the data has no integrity, meaning that operations on the data may not be accurate or consistent. There are also practical problems. If all of the data is stored in one file, then processing the data requires that the entire file be processed. Producing a roster for an individual course, for example, means that every record needs to be processed even if it's not relevant. This is inefficient and error-prone. Updating data also presents problems. If a student changes their email, which record do we change? There are several records with different emails for the same person. Changing all of them may mean that we lose data. Finally, there are other issues including concurrency and security. If the data is stored in one file and each operation must process the entire file, multiple threads or processes or applications cannot access the data at the same time. It also means that any process or user that has access to the flat file has access to all of the data. There is no way to define any fine-grained permissions or access. The solution to all of these problems is to use a relational database management system. An RDBMS represents data as tuples, pairs, triples, etc., stored in tables. Such a system associates data between tables using relations. This model was first developed by Edgar Codd in the early 70s at IBM. Each table in a database has columns and rows. Columns, also called fields, have a unique name and data type. A column could hold integers or strings, for example. Each column represents a single piece of data, while each row represents a single record or tuple of data. Each row may have a unique primary key, or PK for short, which identifies each and every record that exists or that may exist in the future. That is, the value of a primary key in a table cannot be the same for any two records. Records in different tables can be related through foreign keys. For example, a student record may have multiple email addresses, which can be stored in a second table. A particular student record can reference multiple email records in the second table through a foreign key. In general, the order of the columns and rows is meaningless. Here's the same data from our flat file, realized as a relational database. The pieces of data are separated into 4 different tables. Various relationships between tables have been defined using foreign keys. We'll revisit this database in detail in subsequent videos. Relational database management systems also provide support for transactions. A transaction is an interaction or batch of interactions with the database treated as one atomic, indivisible unit of work. A transaction is how we interact with the database to manipulate or query data out of it. Such systems also provide data integrity by allowing you to define constraints. You can define constraints to allow or disallow missing null values, or to ensure that numerical values are not negative, for example. There are various types of constraints depending on the database system, which can be quite sophisticated. Relational database systems also support what are known as the ACID principles. Atomicity refers to the fact that transactions are an all or nothing process. If a transaction involves multiple queries to the database and one of those queries fails, then it is as if none of the queries had ever occurred. For example, suppose we attempt to insert three records in a single transaction, and the second one fails. Perhaps it violates one of the constraints that we defined in the table. Upon failure, it is as if the first record were never inserted at all. The transaction is successful in its entirety or not at all. Consistency means that the transactions will always leave the database in a state that is consistent with all the constraints that you have defined. A database may violate constraints during its query plan, the set of steps it creates to access data. However, upon successful completion, there's a guarantee that the state of the database will be consistent with all of your constraints. Isolation refers to the fact that no transaction interferes with another transaction. If two transactions simultaneously start processing, neither one is aware of the other, and each one interacts with the database as if the other transaction doesn't exist. If transaction A makes changes to the data while transaction B is processing it, B is unaware of the changes. This allows for concurrency in database processing and the scaling of larger applications with multiple threads, applications, and users. Durability means that once a transaction has been committed, that is, completed, it remains so. This protects data and the database from catastrophic errors such as a server crash. Durability ensures that when the server is restored, the database will be restored to a state consistent with its rules and constraints up to the last committed transaction. There are many relational database management systems on the market. Some are free and open source, such as PostgreSQL or MariaDB, while others are commercial with a cost ranging from a few hundred dollars to a few million. Some provide better scalability or a lot of custom features. Others, like SQL Lite, provide a stripped-down RDBMS for embedded applications. There are also databases that are not based on COD's relational database model, commonly referred to as NoSQL databases. Some are key-value pair-based databases that store data not in tables, but in what are essentially associative arrays or maps. There are also graph-based databases that use graph data structures instead of tables. Redis is a database system that offers direct storage of common data structures, such as lists, sets, and hash tables. There are also a lot of companies that offer data storage and data access in a software-as-a-service or SaaS model. You can pay SaaS companies to use their infrastructure and API in your applications to store and access data. Relational database systems have several clear advantages. The data is structured and organized rather than just being there, as in a flat file. Good relational design, using normalization, means that duplication and replication of data is minimized. Updating, accessing, and aggregating data is easier and more straightforward through the use of structured query language. Moreover, all of the problems we observed with the flat file are now solved. Data integrity can be enforced through the design of tables and use of constraints. Relational database management systems are faster and more scalable. They offer security features and portability across different types of systems and provide concurrency for multiple threads and applications. In the next part, we'll get started with working with databases by introducing structured query language, or SQL for short. This is a common programming language used in most relational database systems. It was originally developed at IBM in the mid-70s. Some SQL variants or dialects are not portable. Some database vendors have added their own features to the language that only work on their databases. However, our coverage of SQL would be very general and should work on most common relational database systems. In general, comments can be written using the hash mark, and keywords in SQL are case insensitive. In subsequent videos, we'll examine how to manipulate data in tables. SQL provides a means to perform basic CRUD, that is, means to create, retrieve, update, and destroy data in tables. In SQL, we'll use the keywords insert, select, update, and delete to perform these actions, respectively.